Welcome to the Family Feud Challenge. What is the top answer to this question? Name a kind of business that really treats consumers badly. The survey says the number three answer is collection agency. The number two answer is car repair. What is the number one bullseye answer? You'll get the answer as we play Bullseye on the Family Feud Challenge. Introducing the Cole family, ready for action. Playing against the Anaya family. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. Here's the star of the Family Feud Challenge, Ray Cole.
Thank you very much. Hello to the Anaya family. Welcome to the Cole family. Welcome to the Family Feud Challenge. Our opening question was, name a kind of business that really treats consumers badly. If you said the number one answer is car dealerships, you hit the bullseye. We have two great families ready to battle it out for the chance at possibly more than $20,000. And then, to face our returning champions, the Conlins, awaiting the challenge in the audience. Let's get started. Say hello to the Cole family.
Hi, Ray, how are you?
Good Granger.
We love you, Ray. And we love the Family Feud.
Well, thank you, Granger.
That's why we're here today.
Thank you. Where are you from?
We're from New York.
Excellent. From New York City?
New York, Manhattan. Right.
Great. They're watching you on WCBS right now, and I'm sure they're wishing you well.
Thank you.
Who'd you bring with you? We love you.
Well, thank you, Ray.
Speaking for the people.
My lovely sister with the red hair. Sexy
Hi.
Sarah.
How are you?
This is my brother-in-law, Andrew.
Ray!
My wonderful, wonderful sister is Missy at the second at the end there, and the only mother we have, Catherine at the end.
It's a pleasure to have the Cole family from New York. Let's place $2,500 into your bank. That's the least amount of money you'll play for in Fast Money. If you play Fast Money, if you defeat the Anaya family. How are you, Miguel?
Very good, how are you?
Is it Miguel?
Miguel.
Where are you from?
We're from originally from Mexico, and we've been in the LA for 18 years, has it been?
So Southern California against New York City. This is America. Who did you bring, Miguel?
Okay, this is my studly brother, Fernando. This is my handsome brother, Jorge. My slick brother, Javier. And the guy who's living in my house, our cousin, Stretch.
We're going to place $2,500 into your bank. That might help you get Stretch out of your house. The least amount of money you'll be playing for in Fast Money if you win the feud, but we're going to play the bullseye game right now. Come on, Granger. Right now, you will determine exactly how much you can play for in Fast Money as you determine your own bank. All that count in bullseye are the number one answers. We ask 100 people a question that can add $500 to your bank. Name a way that thieves can break into your car. You have control, Miguel.
Break the window.
Is window the bullseye? Bullseye! $3,000 for the Anaya family. Sarah against Fernando. This question could add $1,000 to the worth of your bank. Name something that interferes when a married couple wants to spend time alone together. Fernando.
Family.
Is family the bullseye? Bullseye! Anaya's built a $4,000 bank as we continue. Good luck, Andy. Jorge, $1,500 will go into your bank if you know the bullseye answer to this. Name someone who is always making promises to you. Andy.
The president.
Well, it didn't say he wasn't keeping them. Let me see. If the president is the bullseye, No.
4 years.
Okay. Jorge, someone who is always making promises to you.
Family.
Is what do you mean exactly? What family member?
Brothers.
Show me siblings for the bullseye. Oh, you missed 1500 with this bullseye answer. May. That's family. Here we go, the $2,000 bank building question. Just get you straight here, Javier. You're looking sharp. How can you make up for missing that last question? Put $2,000 into your bank with this. Listen to it carefully. When you go to an all-night market late at night, name something you're going to buy.
No.
Javier says he gets up late to buy milk for the bullseye. Bullseye! $6,000 for the Inara boys. Stretch, you're living with him?
I spend most of my time there.
Well, nice to have you here, Catherine. $2,500 could go to either family's bank. Catherine, you're ready to cheat, aren't you?
No.
I love you, but I have to be fair. Good luck. You can add it if you slap that buzzer first and know the bullseye answer to this. Name something some guys would rather talk about than talking about girls. Stretch.
Sports.
Is sports the $2,500 bullseye? Bullseye, Catherine, back with your family. $8,500 in the Anaya Family Bank. Cole family, $2,500 in your bank. And that's the money they'll be playing for in Fast Money if they win the feud. And we come back right after this. Drivers, we're back, and it's time to play the feud. Let's go. What were you saying, Granger?
This is it. We gave them the money so they build their steam up, but we're taking it all.
It's a bank. We're going
to.
All right.
We're taking it all.
Let me just take control here, gentlemen, for one moment. The first team to $300, 300 points, can talk the stuff. Right now, you have to do that. Then you can play for your bank. Will the Colts play for $2,500? Or the Anayas for $8,500? More importantly, you'll face our champions sitting in the audience, the Conlins, for that chance to win thousands of more dollars. It is time to stop talking and time to feud. Here's the first question. Top five answers are on that board. We ask 100 people, name something you should do if you begin receiving obscene phone calls. Ranger.
Call the police.
He says police. It's there. One answer, Miguel, is more popular. What should you do if you begin receiving obscene phone calls?
Disconnect the phone.
Disconnect your phone. You think of a steal. Cole family, you'd love to play for that $2,500, wouldn't you? What do you do, Sarah, when you receive obscene phone calls?
I change my number.
Change the number. Here it is, 14. Andy's going to get it.
Okay. Get an unlisted number.
Maybe. Maybe you get an unlisted number. A little hope for the Anaya boys. Hi, Missy. What would 100 people say they would do if they began receiving obscene phone calls?
Ignore them.
Really? Did they say ignore? Gentlemen, think of a steal. You'll have 33 points plus the value of the steal.
Call the telephone company and report it.
Catherine says she's going to keep the family alive by calling the phone company. Bottom of the cell. Granger, listen to the question.
Okay.
Now we ask, gentlemen, can we be polite? We ask 100 people, name something you should do if you begin receiving obscene phone calls. What would be most popular?
Answer them.
Okay.
You never know who's on the other end.
You can steal this first bank. Stretch.
Try to find out who it is.
Try to get them to give their name up.
Try to find out who it is.
All right.
The answering machine answer.
Let the answering machine.
Trace the call.
Oh, hello. Thank you, Columbo. Trace the call, find out. You can go with them or on your own.
Trace the call. Ready?
Yeah!
Go!
Is it a steal? With Trace the Call. Small bank. If you had given me the number one answer to steal, you would have really stolen a larger bank. I don't know what's up there, but I know my mother used to blow a whistle. Oh, yeah, how you doing over there? Show me number one. Hang on. No one said that. Number three. Whistle into the phone. We're going to come right back with more feuding fun. There'll be no obscene phone calls. Find out who will face our champions right after this. We're back. And right now, the Cole family, 41 points, leading the Anayas 0. Here we go. Another face-off. Good luck. Top five answers are on the board to a question that was asked of 100 women. Keep that in mind. Besides her age, what's the next thing a woman lies about the most? Fernando.
Her weight.
Show me weight. Number one. Think of this deal, Cole family from New York. This is what makes the show really interesting. Now, five handsome men are going to get the chance to give their opinion of what they thought 100 women said. Jorge, besides her age, what's the next thing a woman lies about most?
Their rear hair color. Yeah! 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 Yeah!
Judge, what did he say? Oh, their real hair. I thought he said their rear hair color. I missed that.
Next time.
That's what I thought. Hair color. Yeah! 7 points. Congratulations. Javier, what do they lie about most?
Their bra size.
Boys, wait to see if it's there before you do that. Let me see if they lie about that bra size.
Two more.
Stretch.
Come on, baby. Ray, I'm going to have to go with their height.
Yeah! Lie about their height?
Yeah.
You can steal 87 more points, Miguel. Take a guess. 3 seconds. All right. 100 women besides age. Next thing a woman lies about the most. Kevin?
Money.
Money. Missy, anything?
Birthday.
Birthday.
Her age.
Age.
Clothes.
Size for clothes, age, right. Money, up to you, Ranger. Big steal.
We got it.
What is it?
Age.
All right, one more time. Besides her age, Granger.
I can get a different answer.
Yes, quickly.
Her marital status.
You went on your own. Do you steal with her marital status? The family from New York is playing very sharp. Jorge, what are you doing? Get back over there.
I call you up.
Two other answers would have gotten the steal. Number three, women lie about sex life. And they lie about number five, the past. We're going to come right back in the future and find out if the Anayas can fight back to face our champions, the great feud. Feuding on CBS. The Cole family, 130 points on the way to 300. Anayas, 0. Let's go, Jorge. Time for another face-off. If you've just tuned in, let me point out the situation. From New York City, Cole family, you can win the game with this question. Play fast money for your bank of $2,500. You need the question to stay alive, Jorge. But more importantly, your family has a bank of $8,500 you'd like to play for. And you'll play the champs. We double the point value. We ask 100 people this. Name a job that a person might have at a golf club. Andy?
Caddy.
Show me caddy. You really want to think of that steal over there. If you can give me four remaining answers. You are so confident, Granger.
This is it.
And
this
I hate to say it, but you are good. He gave the right answer to get for the steal last time. Andy, you gave, she gave that. Thank you. I'm just checking to make sure you're paying attention. Missy, 100 people across this great land answered a job that a person might have at a golf club.
Golf pro.
Yeah! Are you rolling? The golf pro. Anaya family, don't feel down yet. That 162 points could be yours if you have the right steal answer.
Yeah.
And they start to fall. Catherine, do you golf?
No, I don't. But the maintenance of the course.
Yeah!
So sweet. Show me the golf club maintenance crew. To my friend, the Anayas, I know that you're happier than you appear at this moment. Granger?
Yes. We're not as confident on this one, though. And I'm telling you why. Because
first of all, Granger, you're a lawyer, aren't you?
No, what?
Are you a lawyer?
No, I'm not.
Okay, you just appear so...
And I don't want to be.
Okay.
Anyway, a starter. The starter. Yeah. The starter. The starter. Someone's got to start the golfer.
A job a person might have at a golf club. I'll see if it's there. A starter?
A starter.
What is a starter, from my knowledge? I don't know. I don't play golf.
Well,
I play miniature
teach you.
Ball.
Look, you
small. Let me see a starter. Hope for the United.
I got it.
She's got it to keep
I got
you going.
It. A ranger.
I don't know. Well, let me see the if you're going with a ranger.
Ranger.
A ranger.
You could steal the lead if Andy does not know. Name a job that a person might have at a golf club.
Cashier.
Come on, wrong answer. Let me see cashier.
If
you don't know, they have won the game, Stretch.
Concession stand operator.
Concession stand.
Yeah, concession stand operator.
Receptionist.
Receptionist.
The guy that holds up the names of the player.
The names of the what?
You know how they have those little things like...
Okay, time's up, Fernando. Okay, Miguel. Name a job that a person might have at a golf club for the to stay alive.
Let's go for the concession stand.
Is it concession? They have people that sell merchandise. What was number four would have kept you alive? Bartender.
Concession stand.
What's that?
Concession stand.
Hey, if I were you, I'd take it up with the judge, but I think you're wrong. Number five. Picking up the balls to a great family. You gave it a valiant effort. And handsome, we have nice prizes for you. Give me a smile, Javier. Stay right here, Stretch. Two players are needed right now for Fast Money. Who's first? Who's second? Bye-bye, Andy, off stage. We're going to come right back with our challengers to play Fast Money. $2,500 could go in their pocket before they face our champions waiting in the audience. Don't go away.
Yep, it's a dull, boring morning. 65 degrees. No wind. No clouds. Dull.
And yeah, I heard it through the grapevine.
Drixoral is. Sudafed isn't. Drixoral is. Contac isn't. Drixoral is the only 12-hour cold medicine you can buy that was once a prescription and is still available in its original prescription strength. Drixoral.
At Sears, you can shop for hundreds of America's favorite brands with different prices, features, and styles. And they all come with one very important extra. Sears' guarantee of complete satisfaction or your money back. It's one more way you can count on me.
Saturday, Granny knows what men fear.
And can handle death. The only thing that scares them more is birth and foreplay.
It's Granny's turn. Then on Brooklyn Bridge.
You're going to marry Katie Monahan, aren't you?
Frankie Beyondalillo got married at 14.
See him?
And that was his second marriage.
Brooklyn Bridge after Granny's turn Saturday.
We're back with the Cole family going for $2,500 in Fast Money and waiting to face our champions, the Conlins. Sitting in the crowd, we place 15 seconds on that clock, please. Good luck, Sarah. We ask 100 people, name something specific that people put in Easter baskets.
Eggs.
At what age should people retire?
16.
A city that begins with the letter P.
Paris.
The newspaper section that people read first.
Sports.
Something that people do to their fingernails.
Cut them.
Turn around. Yeah! Yeah! Something that people put in Easter baskets, you chose. Egg survey chose 51.
Oh, yes.
At what age should people retire, you said? 60. How old are you, Judge? 21. What did the survey say? 17.
All right.
A city that begins with the letter P you chose. Paris, Kentucky, the survey said? 2. Newspaper section, people read first, you liked. Sports survey liked? 20. People do to their fingernails. You like cut them, survey liked? Yes, sir, 12, you're over 100. Here comes your partner, 98 away from $2,500. Bring it home, Andy. As we put 20 seconds on the clock, you'll face America, and we will reveal your partner's answers. Do it. We ask 100 people, name something specific that people put in Easter baskets.
Eggs.
Try again.
Little toasty things.
At what age should people retire?
65.
A city that begins with the letter P.
Paris.
Try again.
Pass.
A newspaper section that people read first.
Sports.
Try again.
Business.
Something that people do to their fingernails.
They cut them. Polish them.
A city that begins with P. Turn around. The OP.
All right.
You need some big ones. Something specific that people put in Easter baskets. You could have made up a lot of ground with this toasty things. Survey said?
0.
Eggs number 1. People should retire, you thought? Great at 65, survey said.
Come on.
13. 70 was number 1.
70?
That's what I said, Andy. A city that begins with the letter P. You passed and did not get to it. Pittsburgh, number 1. Which section do people read first in the newspaper, you said? Business, survey said. 3. Comics, most important. You're going for $5 a point. People do to their fingernails? They polish them. Survey said. 33. Bite was number 1. We give you $5 a point as you go back with your family. $755. The Conlins are ready. Don't go away. It is not over. A high-stakes championship fuse worth $20,000 right after these very important messages.
More Family Feud coming up. Welcome to the Family Feud Challenge. What is the top answer to this question? As a child, name a reason why your parents sent you to your room. The survey says the number 3 answer is fighting. The number 2 answer is being bad. What is the number 1 bullseye answer? You'll get the answer as we play Bullseye on the Family Feud Challenge. Introducing our returning champions, the Conlon family. Ready for action. Playing against the challengers, the Cole family. On your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. Here's the star of the Family Feud Challenge, Ray Cohn.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Welcome to the Conlon family. Welcome to the Cohn family. And welcome to the Family Feud Challenge. Opening question. As a child, name a reason why your parents sent you to your room. If you said the number 1 answer is talking back, you hit the bullseye. We're going to play that great bullseye game in just a minute, but we want to say hello first to our returning champions, the Conlins. Their second day on the show, Gigi. Tell everybody where you're from.
Pleasantville, New York.
New York. This is going to be a good feud. And tell everyone who you brought.
I brought my husband, Wooder.
Hey, Ray.
Wooder?
Wooder.
My sister-in-law, Terry.
Hi, Terry.
My brother-in-law, Scott.
I know, Ray.
And my sister-in-law, Mary.
It's nice to have you back. We're going to put $5,000 into your account. That is the least amount of money that you could play for in Fast Money if you defeat another family from New York, the Cole family.
Hi, Ray.
Howdy, Granger.
We're so happy to be back.
For the folks who just tuned in, the Granger family were in the first part of our show. I mean, the Cole family.
Okay.
You could have your own last name. You're such a person. Tell everybody who you brought.
I brought the Conrad.
Don't touch my hand, Granger.
Pardon me. I brought my sister, Sarah.
Hello.
I brought her husband.
I think, they're making this up, Judge.
No, we're not. No, we're following along. Andrew. I have my sister down here is Missy. And my lovely, wonderful mother, Catherine.
Excellent family that also has $5,000 in their bank. The least you'll play for, but we want to find out the most you could play for in Bullseye. Let's go right now. Head to the family joint. Let's see you build those banks. All that count are the number one answers. We ask 100 people this question. This will add $1,000 to your bank. Past or present, name a great baseball slugger. Granger?
Babe Ruth.
Is Babe Ruth $1,000 bullseye?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Cole family, $6,000 in their bank. $2,000 will add to someone's bank if you know something worn in the operating room. Sarah?
Mask.
Let me see if mask is the bullseye. Bullseye! We go to $8,000 for the Coles. The Conlins looking to build their bank. $3,000, the worth of a single answer. Name something that has to warm up before you use it. Andy, you have control.
An iron.
Is iron worth $3,000 as the bullseye? Here's your chance. Something that has to warm up before you use it.
Car?
Yes! Is car the bullseye? What was the $3,000 bullseye? Could it be oven? Stove! We missed that one. Make up for it by giving me the bullseye answer to this $4,000 bank building question. Name a supermarket item that comes in a box. Missy.
Cereal.
Is cereal adding $4,000 as the bullseye? Bullseye! Cole family go to $12,000 in their bank. The champions make it to the podium first. This question, Mary, could add $5,000 to one of the family's banks with a single number one answer. Listen carefully. Name one of the pleasurable things that people give up for the sake of their health. That was first and fast, Mary.
Smoking!
Let me see if you get $5,000 in your bank with smoking as the bullseye. Bullseye! Great try, Catherine. The champions have $10,000 in their bank. The Cole family challenging build a bank of $12,000. That's right. We'll be right back to play the feud to see who play Fast Money for the money they just put in their bank. Don't go away. We're back, and it's time to play the feud. Let's go, Randy. Why don't you shake hands with Gigi there? The first family to 300 points will win this game and go on to play Fast Money for a chance at their bankroll. Right now, the champions, the Conlins, $10,000 in their bank. Cole family, $12,000 in their bank. Most importantly, you'll get to come back again. And again and again. Two families, both from New York. Here is the first question that we ask 100 people. We put the top six answers on that board. Listen carefully. This is a great question. How would you describe an ugly blind date whom you were trying to set up with a friend? Gigi?
Good personality.
Let me see good personality. 42, it's the number one answer. Good answer. Champions, you know, Granger, you thought this was going to be a cakewalk.
No,
didn't you?
No.
These folks want to play for their $10,000. Wooder, How would you describe an ugly blind date whom you're trying to set up with a friend?
She's got a great body.
How could she be ugly then? Would her eye? There's some girls I never even knew they had a head. Let me see, she has a great body. We're rolling. Men and women answered this, Terry.
She's got a lot of money.
Yeah, that's good.
Money can't buy you looks, can't buy you looks. Let me see, she's got a lot of money. Not that much. One strike, Scott.
She's got to be great in bed, then.
You would describe an ugly blind date to a friend you're trying to set her up with. I don't know a lot about her, but she is great in bed.
One more! One, Mary!
Think of a steal over there, Cole family. You could get the first bank.
Now, Mary,
keep your family alive. How would you describe an ugly blind date? It's happened to everybody.
She's a lot of fun.
I think Scott already said that when he said she's great in bed. That's a different answer. She is a lot of fun. Yes, got a sense of humor.
That's all right.
I feel terrible because two of those answers apply to me. Gigi, what would you say?
He's got a great job.
Is it a great job to stay alive? Now, the other family from New York. Can you steal it? Help him out.
Good education.
She's got a good education.
Good education. Good.
Andy doesn't have anything. Sarah, help him.
Nice
car. Nice education. Before you answer, you may go with him. You could go on your own.
Yeah. Comes from a great family. Like my family. Like my family, right?
He's very smart. Does he steal with? She comes from a really great family. How would you describe an ugly... What a date when you were trying to set up with a friend. I only know what my mother used to say, and I don't know if it's there. She's big bone. Let me see number two. Nice purse. It is the same as the first?
Why not?
Well, why didn't you say it? Number three, they described him as? Intelligent. Would that have been the same as education? You tried to get you to say it, Granger, but you knew better. Number four.
Interesting.
Very interesting. We're going to come right back with a very interesting feud to see which family will play for their bank. 10,000 or 12 grand? Find out in a moment.
I'd be crazy these days not to safeguard my family against germs. Germs are everywhere.
Safeguard the ones you love.
Safeguard them.
We're back in feuding. Our champions, 47 points. The Cole family zero as we go right now. With another face-off. We are doubling this point value. We just tuned in two great families battling for the championship. Both from New York, coincidentally. A lot of attitude right here on this stage. Top six answers on that board. We ask 100 people. Name a well-known horse.
Secretariat.
Secretariat. Didn't make our survey, would her? A well-known horse. Quickly. Don't say anything. Andy, do you know our survey said a well-known horse?
Mr. Ed.
Did Mr. Ed beat Secretariat out in our survey? Coming down the back stretch, it's Secretariat, Mr. Ed. They're coming around the curve. Mr. Ed's beating my nose. All right, Missy. A well-known horse.
Trigger.
Mr. Ed is up there. Let me see Trigger. It's great to know the level of people in our surveys. It's a lot of great horses, but Mr. Ed and Trigger are the most popular.
I know. How about Seattle Slough?
Seattle?
Slough.
Okay. Seattle Slough. Good try. Great horse. Think of the steel chance.
Come on, Ranger.
I have it, Ray. I have.
You've said that before, and you've been wrong.
But this is right. Okay. This is lack beauty.
Yeah.
Yes! He's there! Yeah. He's there!
Are you
I
right?
He's there.
Well, then you say, show me black beauty.
Show me black beauty!
He's too good. He makes me sick. Very good. Sarah, you're on your way to a clean sweep.
I got it, too.
What?
Silver. Hi-ho, silver.
Show me hi-ho, silver.
Yes.
Here come the challengers, Andy.
Man of War.
Yes.
Going back again with a serious contention, Man of War.
One more.
Missy. That family right over there, the champions, are going to try to steal this bank if you don't know a well-known horse.
Flicker!
Show me Flicker to Sterile. Yes! 162 points plus, Mom.
Pegasus.
Now, Mom.
Pegasus.
Pegasus?
Yes!
Hey, are you alive? You're taking a clean sweep? With Pegasus. We have 168 points challenging the champions. Let's go. Time for another face-off. Mother knows best. Let me just point out the gravity of this situation. I want you to listen carefully because we're going to pick up the pace. Point values tripled. Either team can win. Will you play for $10,000? Will you play for $12,000? Who will be the champions at the end of this? Top six answers there. Name something that people save between the pages of a book.
Carrie. A bookmark.
A bookmark they save. Listen to the question. Name something that people save between the pages of a book.
Money.
Is money on that survey. You can win and play for $12,000 and be the new champion. You can say it. People save between the pages of a book.
Save.
S-A-V-E. 3 seconds.
Airline ticket.
Nothing like it. You just want to just save it forever. Airline ticket? Number one's there, Mom.
I put a flower in between pages.
You just need to speak up, hon. She said a flower.
I would press a flower.
Yeah. Is it up there, a flower? Number one.
Yes.
Ranger, give it to me.
I don't really like this answer, but I think it made the survey. I think. Coupons.
All right,
coupon.
Let me see coupon.
Coupon.
Oh, no.
Think of a steal that could give you a very big lead, maybe a win. Now, Sarah, listen to the question and keep your family alive. Name something that people save between the pages of a book.
A letter.
Is it a letter? Either team is getting close to winning. Andy.
An address.
Is it? He said address. Are you alive with an address? Listen to me carefully. With the proper answer doubled, you could win. Something that people say between the
leaves.
Pages. Leaves.
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 All
I was thinking is leaves.
Now, you can go on your own or with them, Gigi, but you have to try to give me number three. What do you say in 3 seconds?
Go with family. Leaves.
Let's see if you've stolen it with enough points to win the game. Leaves. Number three, 7 double, 258 plus 47. You've won 305. You stay champions. That is the only answer that could have won them the game. There are two answers that would have kept you going.
All right.
You would have played for $12,000, possibly, if you'd said number four. Pictures.
Oh. Right.
How about number six? People say newspaper
clipping.
Let me say, Granger, your family, you were wonderful. Sorry we're going to lose you. We have nice display. God bless you. Nice job. Stay right here. I need two players right now for $10,000. Are you first? Bye-bye, Scott. We'll be right back with the Conlins to play Fast Money against the Big Board.
Hi, I'm Regis Philbin. You know, I've been suffering with back pain for years. I tried all these rubs. They worked, but I smelled so medicine-y. Then I discovered Odor-Free Aspicream. I just rub an Aspicream for hours of concentrated relief right where I hurt. It relieves the pain fast, and it's odor-free. That's the difference. Go ahead, try Odor-Free Aspicream yourself. With Aspicream, you'll get fast relief, hours of relief, and Aspicream is aspirin-free.
This castle once had 26 bathrooms.
It'd be nice if one of them still worked.
Why?
What if my diarrhea comes back?
Relax. You took my Imodium AD caplets.
Just once. I usually take the pink stuff two or three times.
Imodium AD is much better.
Imodium AD caplets are so effective, they often work in one dose. Instead of dose after dose after dose, like the pink stuff.
Ready to go?
Before the sunset?
Imodium AD for diarrhea, the choice for one dose relief.
Just when I need someone to love me. Just when I think the world's too cold. There you are, right there beside me. There you are in my heart, standing by me once again. There
Sheba, because you cherish your cat.
6 months ago, I'm at the dentist, not feeling overly anxious, when I heard that unforgettable word, cavities. Doctor, I said, is there any hope?
Mandy, he said, you gotta brush twice a day the right way.
If your child brushes every day for 6 months with Crest, the dentist's choice, their next checkup will be great. And we're so sure you'll be satisfied, we'll give you a money-back guarantee.
So I brush with Crest, and I'm sitting pretty.
Crest, great checkups in 6 months guaranteed.
Ain't life grand?
We are back with the Conlon Family Champion. Playing Fast Money for $10,000 in a bank they built and now deserve to win. Are you ready, Gigi?
Ready as I'm ever going to be.
We place 15 seconds on the clock. We ask 100 people, name something you have to do to have a successful vegetable garden.
Hoe it.
The normal wait in a supermarket line.
5 people.
A way to make a small room seem larger.
Paint it.
A very fast car.
Maserati.
Something that people soak in their sink.
Clothes.
Turn around. You gave me 5, Gigi. Something that you have to do to have a successful vegetable garden. You said? Hoe it. Survey said? 7 agreed. How did you do with a normal wait in a supermarket line? You said? 5 people. Survey said? 0. A way to you to make a small room seem larger. You said, paint it. What did the survey think of that? 35 agreed. A very fast car you like? The very fast Maserati. Does it get you points fast? What the survey say? 8 only. People soak in their sink. You did not hesitate to say, close. Survey said. Bam! 43. Back with your family. Scott, you are 107 points away from your $10,000. While we place 20 seconds on that clock, we reveal the answers given by your partner. Take another breath. All right, I'm ready too. We ask 100 people, name something you have to do to have a successful vegetable garden.
Plant flowers.
Okay, a normal wait in a supermarket line.
5 minutes.
A way to make a small room seem larger.
Put mirrors on a wall.
A very fast car.
Porsche.
Something that people soak in their sink.
Shirt.
Try again.
Sweater.
All clothes included.
Their socks.
All right, Scott, you must do it in 4. You need 107. Oh, something that you have to do to have a successful vegetable garden. You said you can always get bigger carrots when you plant tulips. What did the survey say? 0.
Yes.
Water it, number 1. Now you have to do it with the 3 remaining answers. Normal wait in a supermarket line, you said? 5 minutes, survey said? 27. Here we go, 10 minutes was number 1. A way to make a small room appear larger, you said? To put mirrors in that room, the survey said?
Yes.
The comeback kid is Scott. 10, the number 1 answer was Porsche. What am I talking about? Coming up here. Name a very fast car. You said Porsche. Could it be the number 1 answer? Could 30 people have said it? Could you get $10,000? What did the survey say? Yes! No last answer clothing, number 1 in a sink. Mirrors make make a room appear larger, you're coming right back with champions $10,000 richer.
It's a dull bore.
From Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud. Mark Goodson, Television Productions.